I was sent an Anet A8 3D printer by Gearbest. It's a very affordable Prusa i3 clone. I've always wanted to make a 3D printer, but it's been a little beyond me. I had tried to build a Delta with Nathan from Opentronic back in 2013, but we got stuck with the software and an alternative interest in brewing. I think my understanding of CNC has dramatically improved since I've built my own machine and controller, and this machine comes with several instruction manuals. Anyway, I'll start with what's in the box.
Okay, in the top we've got the bearing, the linear bearings, some plastic bits, a massive bag of machine screws, some wires, we've got the heat bed, there must be a heat sensor there, got another bit of aluminium, also a few tools, some more wire, and then a plug, which the wire seems to have actually melted onto the polystyrene. Interesting. The next box has some of the larger acrylic parts. There's a handful in there. Got the display. It's a nice box. Looks like it could have some soap in there. Got the main board here. I'm not sure which version this is or what it's running. There's also a timing belt, a USB pen, USB cable, fan, and heatsink. And in the bottom, we've got the rest of the components, the acrylic parts, and cable chains over here. We've got the stepper motors, which have been pre-assembled. We've got the heating element for the plastic. I like to have some machine threaded rod. Some look like trapezoidal and the rest looks like normal threaded rod. And there's some straight rod at the back. The fan, I think these are the bits that... Okay, that's interesting. This hasn't been 3D printed. I'd also asked for a sensor, a bed leveling sensor, which actually came broken, but I'll be able to glue that back together with some chloromethane. And they also sent me some filament. I asked for PLA just because it's a little bit easier to work with. You don't need to heat everything up as much. But they sent me ABS instead. I also asked for red. I wanted China red, and they sent me UK grey. Okay, I'm not going to tell you how to assemble this because there's so many videos doing that. I'm just going to get on with it and show you some of the stages which may be useful for you to see. I may come back and put washers on these. Just put this piece onto here. I'm going to do the other side of it now. I think it goes that way. I'm going to put a bit of machine grease in there. Definitely going to unscrew these and square that all up. Just pushing it that way. managed to break the snips that came in the box. Okay, I did do a bit of research about this machine, and one of the things that I noticed was the contact, the terminal here, the plug that fits onto it is a well-known point of fires. What I may do is use shielded terminals, maybe even get some fiberglass shielding or sleeving, which I can cover the wires up after I've actually soldered them directly onto the terminals that I need. But I'll save that for another time. Okay, a week later, I'm just going to make sure the belt lines up, so the pulley's been put on quite to one side, and I think it doesn't look square or straight to me. I've actually got some flanged head machine screws. These are just a little bit wider than the machine screws that I've been sent, the mushroom head ones. I think they will actually hold a bit better. They're a little bit shorter. These are 16mm while these are 18, but they still hold the nuts. So I'm just going to do the rest of what I'm working on with these. Right, I just went and had a break, watched some socialist meme caucus, and then it all suddenly clicked into place. There's a grub screw in there and I couldn't see it because this area isn't well lit. So I've just undone that a little bit. You don't read the manual or pay attention. Right, go straight in. What I don't get with the heat bed is that they haven't used insulated fireproof wire. And obviously for the other heating element here, they have, which is what you're meant to do. I anticipated this, so I bought some fiberglass insulated wire, which I will replace for the heat bed. And secure that onto there.
I'm jumping ahead after putting the extruder and belt on the gantry. I managed to break the stainless steel Teflon pipes which connect the heating element and feed the filament. There probably should be a couple of these in the box, but they are quite cheap to replace. Just don't over tighten them when you're at this stage of the build.
I'm just going to carry on and then I'll replace the broken part when I get it. sure the wire comes out of the groove so you don't pinch it. Just put the display panel on. You can see I've got a nut between the circuit board and the back panel just to space it out so the plastic isn't pushed against there. I've made the spool holder and added a few of the wires. But I can't really do any more now until I get the 8mm filament stainless steel tube that I broke. Obviously I just over tightened it, but I am getting another one in the post, so only a few dollars or quids. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to do before I put everything else away is fix the bed leveling sensor. The plastic bit actually broke on the way to me. Instead of getting them to send me another one, which to be honest would be a bit of a waste of time, because I can actually glue this with this stuff here, which is liquid solvent cement or dichloromethane. So the way this glue works is you have to push the pieces that you want to join together. In this case I'm going to use a brush, wet it, and you just brush the glue into the crack, and it uses a process called capillary action to just draw the glue between the two areas. Changed over to some longer machine screws. Okay, I'm going to stop here and wait for the next things to come in the post and then carry on later. Okay, another week has passed and a whole lot of other stuff has turned up to the studio. Got these shielded crimps which I'll be using to replace the wiring on the heat bed. Also got two different types of tape, one for printing on and one for heat insulation. Got a few other nozzles. See the variety there. And the thing I broke from the previous week, these pieces of threaded rod with a hole in the center for the PTFE and the filament to go through.
I'm crimping on the insulated spade terminals. They fit quite well, but they are technically not the correct fitting for the type of terminals on the heat bed. What I could do is crimp the correct opposite terminals onto a piece of heatproof fiberglass wire and solder that directly onto the heat bed. But this is a good improvement from what was already there, so I'm going to stick with it for now. I'm placing a piece of borosilicate glass with PEI plastic on top. This didn't come with the 3D printer, so I had to buy those parts separately and stick them together. I've made a separate video about the build platform and I'll link to that in the information card. I leveled the bed manually with a feeler gauge and then installed the software and drivers. It isn't as simple as plugging in and playing with this 3D printer, but the software setup time wasn't that long or too difficult. I'm not going to go over the install because it's documented in the instructions which came with this machine, but I will make another video showing how I installed an updated firmware called Skynet, which will allow me to use a bed leveling probe.
Really impressive, and it seems to be working quite well the first time around. The problem is the fan. This fan here isn't running for some reason. So this is my first print. Don't know what this means. No. Mandarin, but it looks pretty cool. I had a few problems at the beginning. Some of the filament didn't come out directly on the bed. I think it was the nozzle was a little bit too high still, and it looks a little bit loose. So I'm going to have to change some of the settings. I'm hoping that just slowing it down should be enough, but it's pretty cool. PLA is a really nice material to print with. The only other problem I had was the fan wasn't spinning when I thought it was going to spin. This piece here is a little bit too high, and when it's in and pushed all the way, see, that's not turning. If I pull that down a bit, it can turn.
To use the bed leveling sensor, I had to install an updated firmware for the controller called Skynet, but because I'm using a piece of borosilicate glass with PEI polyethamide plastic stuck to it, it's too thick for the sensor to work. So I will come back to that in another video. This video has turned into another long one. I will link to some of the relevant video sources and forums which have helped me while constructing this machine. And I will warn you now, I have noticed there are different build versions depending where you look. All I can say is please be careful if you decide to buy this 3D printer. If you don't like reading, don't get into 3D printing, because you need to read around the subject. It's as simple as that. There are a lot of essential improvements you need to do to the machine to improve print quality but also safety. The main upgrade I did during the video was use 2.5mm core heat resistant fiberglass cable for the heat bed and insulated terminal to connect to it. I am also planning to use MOSFETs to connect the power supply to the heat bed and the extruder heating element. I have to admit, I'm very impressed with the initial print, and I'd like to thank Gearbest again for sending this out to me. As I said earlier, there'll be relevant links in the description below. Don't forget to sacrifice your thumb, and thanks again for watching. Thank you.